Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we just want to thank you. Oh, Daddy is here on the phone, on Facebook. We want to welcome everyone to Shekinah World, a product of Shekinah International Ministries, where we are empowered, where we are educated, where we are enlightened by the word of the Almighty God, so we can discover to recover. In the name of Jesus, somebody under the sound of our voice, you will discover, and you will recover it all in the name of Jesus. So we welcome you. We welcome our Father and the Lord. Daddy, welcome, sir. God bless you, sir.
Bless you.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So we welcome you, and we know that we are all ready to serve the Almighty God. We are ready to pray. This is our weekly Thursday prayers for the nations of the world, U.S., Nigeria, and other nations of the world. As you join us to pray together, you know, the Bible says we should pray without ceasing. So God wants us to pray unto him to hear our voice. And we will all cry unto him, and he will answer us quickly, immediately, effectively, in the name of Jesus. On this note, we have our Father in the Lord in the house, and our mommy, Pastor Abimbola, is coordinating the prayer for tonight. Are you ready, ma? Are you ready? Can you hear me, ma? You need to unmute, ma. Praise the Lord. So, Daddy is here. So, Daddy, please open us up with prayer, ma, sir. So, Pastor Abimbola can take over.
Glory be to the Father, to Amen. The Son, to the Holy Spirit, Amen. As the beginning is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. For the Lord, we thank you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
For giving us another opportunity to assemble before the throne of grace.
Yes, Lord.
For this connection, for this online ministration, Lord God, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
You are the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end.
Yes, Lord.
You have never lost any battle. Yes. You are the one that constantly inspires us,
yes,
to come together and pray. You say, we are two or three are gathered together in your name, you name their name. Yes. We believe you, oh Lord God, we believe you. We believe that today you are always, you are always in our name.
Yes,
and today,
Lord,
it will not be an exception.
Amen.
Today you do what you have never done before.
Yes,
you will,
Lord,
show your glory. Say the glory belongs to you. All, yes, flesh has seen together.
Yes,
the mouth,
Lord,
of the Lord has spoken it. Because,
yes,
we are here in one accord, mighty Almighty, do what nobody else can do.
Yes,
in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Amen. In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Yes. Pastor Abimbola, over to you. Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you,
Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, because it's another day that the Lord has made, the,
yes,
day of joy, the day of gladness.
Yes, Lord.
That we can carefully speak to prayer, to answer prayers, and to lead us.
Amen.
Because the mighty name of Jesus, that we said we are praying for nation. We are praying for Asia. We are praying for Europe. We are praying for Australia, America. And what's the other one?
All the nations of the world.
Nations of the world. Yeah. So we know that the Lord is with us. He says we should. It is a commandment.
Yes.
Especially for Jerusalem today, because they stay for the good of Jerusalem.
Yes.
We want to say that Jerusalem of itself, not to have the families of the beginning. But what I see. I pray for the nations, and I also pray for Jerusalem.
Amen. Amen.
Because, you know, the reason why, one of the reasons why Christ has not come is waiting for his people to accept.
Daddy,
him.
Can you hear her?
No.
Ah.
No. No.
Daddy, no.
He's on Facebook.
Yeah, Daddy's on,
okay,
Facebook. He's on Facebook.
Can you hear me now?
Daddy.
Yes, yes.
Uh-huh. One, yes. They can, he can hear you now.
Okay, let me see if I call you.
Uh-huh.
What picture can you see to know?
And this one, Let me be sure this one's volume. Yeah, this one's volume is up enough. And that's why we're using the laptop for Zoom now. So we can.
Okay, I'll increase my volume.
Okay.
Can you hear me now, sir?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, he can hear you, ma.
I hear me now. Okay.
Yes.
That is not my volume. So we said that the Lord said we should pray for Jerusalem.
Yes.
And I want to think that Jerusalem, that is Jerusalem.
Hmm.
And most world, like people misinterpret it.
Okay.
They will pray for God as well.
Hmm.
So as we work with us too.
Amen. Amen.
So I want to ask Reverend Oloko to please start with the next 15 minutes.
Daddy, she said you can start prayers for the next 15 minutes.
Are you sure? Let's be sure that you heard me.
Okay, okay. Daddy,
Daddy,
can you hear her? She's asking you.
Should I try to go to Zoom, mister? I can only hear you, not you, but not her.
Uh-huh. She said you should check your check phone here, Daddy. But you have volume phone here, low.
Uh-huh.
Check it, yeah. Okay. Yeah, check, sir. Only gelato, don't you? Welcome, everybody. Yeah. Welcome, welcome.
Yeah. So, hi.
His volume is high, too. Pastor Bimbola.
Okay, sir. What I said is that should please take us for the next 15-20 minutes on our prayer for just a topic of your choice from all the prayer points I mentioned.
Daddy, she said you should take the next 15 minutes to pray. Pray as the for nations or for Jerusalem, US and other nations by the prompt of the Holy Spirit.
You should make a choice.
Yes.
That you should.
Okay. Can you let us know if he's hearing? You know.
Okay.
He has to hear me, and I have to hear him.
Okay.
Okay. So, glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit.
Of your choice for the next
beginning is now and ever shall be, world without end. All this time, all along, we have been praying, but today I feel like changing our technique of praying. We have been praying, but this time around, we want to hand over everything unto the Lord. Okay? We want to hand over to the Lord, who is called El Elyon, the Most High God. You know, because he said the battle is the Lord. When God is the one fighting the battle, we don't need to do anything. You know, just as in the days of old, the children of Israel, they were confronted by enemy forces. But when the Lord takes over the warfare, the battle, the children of Israel did not have to do anything. They just have to relax and stay simple. Moses told them, the Lord told Moses, he said, Moses, tell the Israel and the children of Israel that the Egyptians they are looking at today, they will see them no more because I, the Lord, I will fight their battle. Today, we are also calling upon God. Today, we are asking for divine intervention. When we are confronted with all these forces, the only thing we can do is to call on divine intervention. We have been praying all along, and it looks as if to the unbeliever, it will look as if today the Lord is not answering our prayer. Whereas God is always answering our prayer, he's just waiting for an opportune time. He wants us to surrender everything. He does not want us to do it on our own. He wants us to surrender everything unto him. So, for divine intervention, we are only going to deal with only three aspects of divine intervention. How does divine intervention work and when does it work? Divine intervention, it comes into play when beloved of God are in distress and without hope. When in distress and without hope, okay, then divine intervention will kick in. Okay, in the book of Exodus chapter 15, verses 9 through 11, he's talking about the children of Israel who by the Red Sea they were worried and with the Anari. Yeah, Exodus 15, verses 9, 10, 11. He said, the enemy said, I will pursue, I will overtake, I will divide the spoil. My Lord shall be satisfied upon them. I will draw my sword, my hands shall destroy them. But the Lord said, no, thou this blow. The Lord didn't respond. He said, thou this blow with thy wind. The seas covered them. They sank as lead in the mighty water. Okay? When they sank in the mighty water, then something happened. Then we the whole world saw it that, wow, we have never seen this before. Mm. Say, who is like unto thee, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like thee? Glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonder. Okay? And he said, who is like unto thee, O Lord? Who is like unto thee, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like thee, glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders? Hallelujah. Who is like unto thee, O Lord? Who is like unto thee, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like thee, glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders? Hallelujah. One more time. Who is like unto thee, O Lord? Who is like unto thee, O Lord, among the gods? Who is like thee, glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders? Hallelujah. God is able. God is able. He's always able. So the Lord, we saw what the Lord did. When we handed over the problem of the Egyptian, Pharaoh and his Egyptian army, when we handed it over to the Lord, he took control. We did not raise up an arm. We didn't do anything. We just observe and look, because the battle is the Lord. Because El Elyon is at war. When El Elyon is at war, the Most High God, when he's at war, let the whole world keep silent before him. We are told that the Lord God is in his holy temple. Yes, let the whole world keep silent before him.
Yes, Lord.
If only we know. Mm. If only we know. Mm. The problem of this world, if only we know that El Elyon is still in charge.
Yes.
But now, right now, what do we do? It looks as if to say God is on vacation. Mm. And our God is never on vacation.
Yes.
We just need to get our priority right and let the owner of the battle fight the battle.
Yes.
Okay, that's first one. Okay? When beloved of God have been tormented and oppressed, then God has to come to the rescue. How did it happen? The three Hebrews, they were being tormented by the king, okay, in the days of old. And they said, if you don't denounce your God, don't deny God, we shall throw you into this fire. The boy said, we don't care, do whatever we want to do. The Lord whom we serve, he will deliver us. And even if he does not deliver us, we will still not bow down for idols. And divine intervention came, because the Lord knows our heart. He knows our heart. He knows that we really trust him. Whether we die, just like Esther, he said, if I die, I die. But we are brought forth for a time like this. We are the Esther of this time. We are the three Hebrews of this time.
Yes.
We know that the Lord God of all Jehovah is his name. Yes. El Elyon is his name. He's the one that will fight this battle.
Yes.
Look at all these Boko Haram and the Hasmen. Look at what they have been doing all this time. Every day they come with fury. They blow with their fury as if to say they are God. They are trying to supplant our God. They are trying to make our God look like he's a no God. They are trying to make themselves God instead of the God Almighty. They may be mighty, but our own God is Almighty. He fights without a weapon, and he will come to our rescue. Amen. And the Lord is saying to the three Hebrews, he said, fear not in hands of Lord Jesus. Nothing else is to be feared. Their father cannot come near thee. Devils uprising as of you. Devils uprising as of you. When El Elyon is in control. When Elyon is at the battle front, God will always fight our battle. We know that at the end of the time, we will rejoice. We will rejoice. Amen. When all these dust have settled down, we will rejoice. I know we will rejoice. And another third point, the third point I want to deal with this morning, I mean this afternoon, is when we are deceived by wicked neighbors, when we are deceived by wicked neighbors, then divine intervention will kick in. How do we know that? The Sennacherib in the days of old, he came, he threatened King Hezekiah. He said, I will whoop you, I will kick you. Don't you know me? Don't you know I am a terrorist? Don't you know I am wicked? Don't you know I'm this one that? And the Lord told them, don't worry. He took the matter to the Lord. He took the letter to the Lord and laid before the altar of God. We are this very day laying the same letter we are receiving from these husbands. These people who want to exterminate the whole of Christendom in our time, in this generation. We are receiving the letter from them, and we are bringing this letter before El Elyon, the one that fights all battles without a weapon. Okay? But the Lord is saying in our language, he said, hey, Lisha, oh, hey, Lisha. In English, well, the nearest equivalent to the people who speak English here, because it's our son said, it is not possible. If you have God as your savior, if the enemy will not have power over you. You can just also equally say, I am delivered, praise the Lord. I am delivered by his word. Once I was bound by the chains of Satan, I am delivered, praise the Lord. We will have God to praise the Lord. Yes. Okay? What is the way out? What is the way out of this predicament? Okay? Elyon has a way out for us. And we look at this way out, only three prayer points. Way out. Isaiah 29, verse 5. But he said what he will do to the adversary. Isaiah 29, verse 5. He said, moreover, the multitude of thy servants shall be like dust, like small dust. And the multitude of the terrible ones shall be as sharp that passeth away. Yea, they shall be as an instant suddenly. Okay? The Lord will fight them suddenly. The Lord will do whatever wants to do unto them. Because we are the apple of his eye. He will never allow the power of darkness to subdue us.
Amen.
Because light, power of darkness can never subdue, can never overcome the power of life.
Amen.
It is not possible. Say, never possible. It is not possible. Jehovah God is the one that will do it. Those are the three prayer points. We want to pray now. Now that we are surrendered into the whole into the hands of the living Lord, we are calling upon Elyon now to come to our rescue and go and fight the battle.
Yes,
not only in Nigeria, but in other parts of the world where Christendom is under attack. Christians and Christendom, they are under attack. By power that want to exterminate Christendom, we want to call upon God now, the owner of his church. He said, I will build my church and the gate of hell will not prevail against it. We want to call upon him now in prayer that Jehovah God will go now and fight the battle. He said, we do not have to raise up an arm. We don't have any arm. We don't have any weapon. Our adversaries, they are armed to the teeth. But our God will fight without a weapon. He's the one that will fight it. We are going to pray now that Jehovah God will go and fight the battle. El Elyon, come to the rescue. He's the only one who can do it. Nobody else can do it. But the only one that can do it is El Elyon, the God Almighty.
God Almighty.
He's the only one who can do it. So he's the only one that can fight this battle. He's the only one who can set it this
far. Heaven
and earth will pass away, but not a single word of his
come to our rescue, Almighty God.
Mighty Almighty, come to our rescue.
Heal
the world of defense around everyone.
In the name of Jesus, come to our rescue. Come to our rescue in Nigeria. Let not the power of the enemies overcome us in the name of Jesus. My Father, my God, make a way where there is no way. Destroy the power of darkness in the mighty name of Jesus.
Let the glory of God shine.
Yes, yes.
Let the glory of God shine.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, 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 yes.
Destroy the power of darkness.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We raise up our voice one more time.
Yes.
Psalm 57 verse 3. We are still calling upon El Elyon to come to the rescue. He said, He, El Elyon, shall send from heaven.
Yes, Lord.
And save me, save us from the reproach of him that will swallow us up.
Say yes, Lord.
He shall send forth his mercy and truth. Okay?
Amen.
We are being, look at it. Majority of people, the people that are causing trouble, they are minority. But they are armed to the teeth by the power of darkness.
Yes.
They can call it international conspiracy of the devil to come against Christ, to come against the body of Christ. But we shall call for mercy.
Yes.
For mercy. Say, we do we know. And the Lord God upon Jehovah, the El Elyon is his name. He said, he shall send from heaven and save us.
In the name of Jesus. We destroy Fulani, Fulanization. We destroy Islamization. In the name of Jesus. Not on your watch, Almighty God. Do not forsake us, Almighty God. Do not forsake your children, Almighty God. In the name of Jesus. We say capital no to Fulanization. We say capital no to Islamization. In the mighty name of Jesus. It's not possible. It's not going to happen. In the mighty name of Jesus. Our Father, our God, will not fold his hands and see the work of the wicked, you know, thriving in Nigeria, in the mighty name of Jesus.
You are our God.
You have never lost a battle. You have never lost a war. You will not lose this war in the name of Jesus. Our Father and our God, you will fight this battle and you will win in the name of Jesus. And people will live in peace. In the name of Jesus, there shall be no more killing. Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
And finally, on this point, still imploring the Elyon to handle the matter.
Yes.
Because we are just making the request. The owner of the whole world is the one that will fight this battle.
Yes.
Psalm 97 verse 5. So I'm using as 97 verse 5. We are told that in the presence of the Lord, there is fullness of joy, and by his right hand, there is pleasure forevermore.
Yes,
okay,
yes.
And the present, whenever God is present, one evil nature will bow down.
Yes,
okay. Well, he said, he's lightning and lightning the world. Okay, the earth saw and tremble. Okay, and now the earth upon which we are walking, we are told that it will tremble.
Yes.
Why? Because of the presence of the Lord. In the presence of the Lord, this thing will happen. His mental. Whenever the presence of the Lord is in position, he said, all protocol observed. He heals melted like wax.
Like wax.
His will melt like wax.
Yes.
At the presence of the Lord.
Yes.
At the presence of the Lord of the whole earth. God is the Lord of the whole earth, not just in Nigeria. At the presence, anywhere the presence of the Lord is manifested.
Yes.
Oh, miracles happen.
Yes, Lord.
Mountains are subdued.
Yes, Lord.
Hills are melted.
Yes, Lord.
The power of the adversary are subdued.
Yes,
Lord. The glory of God will shine.
Yes.
Mighty Almighty. Please, Lord. Lord, yes. God, according to the scripture, let all the, what are the ills that were met in Nigeria? Oh, the Boko Haram onslaught, the harassment of the harassment. Oh, Lord God, the evil politician, the Fulanization of Nigeria.
Agenda.
Those are the mountains we are confronted with now. Those are the ills that are
Those are the ills that we are destroying, that we are dismantling, in the name of Jesus. We're calling on the Alpha and the Omega to come, to destroy their power. Let their power melt. Let their power melt. Let them melt away. Let them melt away like wax. In the name of Jesus, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Your presence is in Nigeria. Your presence is all over. In the mighty name of Jesus, even in the wilderness, even in the bush that they are hiding, Father, go there and destroy them. In the mighty name of Jesus, let them see your presence. Let them see your power. Let them know that you are the commander in chief of the universe. In the mighty name of Jesus, Daddy, make a way where there is no way. In the mighty name of Jesus,
yes.
For the flag bearer, those people that are fighting for freedom, Father, whatever they call them, whatever they call them, shall not in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, yes, Lord, you will be with them, you will carry them on, you will back them, you will empower them, in the mighty name of Jesus, you will empower your children in the name of Jesus. Yes, our God has never lost anybody. And concerning the Yoruba nation, Middle Belt nation, Biafra nation, Father, come to our rescue. Let your children live in peace. Let your children live in peace in their land. In the mighty name of Jesus, give them peace, peace like that of the river. In the name of Jesus, our Father and our God, we thank you.
Yes. Before the Amalekite.
Yes.
Let all the forces of the Amalekite tremble before us. Let them tremble in the name of Jesus.
They shall tremble. They shall fall in the mighty name of Jesus. The forces of the Amalekite over Nigeria, over all our nations, you must fall. You must fall in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Almighty God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. Papa, we thank you. King of Glory, we thank you. Ayoraye, we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank God for that.
Yes.
We're going to pray again in that line. We're going to pray because God says
your voice is low, ma.
Okay, there's a message that there is a piece of news in BBC that says the conflict in northeast of Nigeria.
Okay.
That it kills 300,000 children.
Eh?
Yes. All those conflicts, they added the children. That's all the reports that were being given in the past, that they are not true.
Oh my God. 300,000 children?
That's what the United Nations report.
United Nations report, okay.
Yeah. What counts? That's what the Nigerian government has been giving us is a lie. That no truth is 300,000 children.
Oh my God.
It's so unfair.
Unfair.
Northern terrain.
Okay.
The north.
Okay.
Terrain. I don't know much, but there's a place called Kebbi here.
Kebbi. Kebbi is in Niger State.
Okay.
Welcome back, sir.
They say that.
Yes, sir.
So children just got abducted a few hours ago.
Eh? Daddy, Daddy.
And it's caring for them.
Yeah.
Because they are saying that Kebbi is normally is the most peaceful in that area.
In Kebbi, they just abducted some children.
Wow. So that is it needs to be the most peaceful.
Terrible.
And see what they are doing. I mean, for it to happen there is shocking.
Hey, Jesus.
And they are major rights in Jesus. So we are going to pray.
Hmm.
We don't know who these people are.
Hmm.
Because that's why I said I don't know the terrain. Because
me too.
Yeah, I know that there are lots of Christian states or towns in the north.
Yes.
So if it's a religious matter, and the religious matter goes with education, because it's those that are Christians that are agitating to go to school over there.
Yes.
Religious matter that the Lord just have to help. When we were praying, when that first attack happened, and the southerners, we were praying there, Lord, it was many years ago. So a lot of us are including, we were so ignorant about the terrain. Some people don't even believe. Some people don't think that everybody is outside, you know.
That's what they believe in. Yeah.
Until when everything starts to come out, and people are against Hausas.
Mm.
So I don't know if these heavy people are Hausas, which I think they are, from what I can read here.
Okay.
So we just need to pray. Because these people are crying too. I've seen a lot of posts. They are crying that they want to be away from this planet.
Mm.
That they have enslaved them.
Yes. They took over their land, they took over everything that belonged to them, and they imposed themselves on them.
So that's why they are now, you know, trying to come down south. So, you know, all these things are very, very, very painful.
Mm.
And then to come into our own dear president is traveling again for medical checkup. I don't know what he's checking up.
Yeah. He's going for another medical. Oh, Masalo.
2 months now, 1 month. So maybe he has some kind of disease that he has to go.
Hey.
You know, but you know, what we just know is that we have the expertise. We have the We have everything. In those days, UCH. They said, it wasn't my mom that was telling me that my mom was the retired bishop. Said, the king of Saudi Arabia,
yes.
For treatment in the
yes. The UCH was the number one hospital.
That place is like a ghost town. I don't know what to even call it. You have to take care and everything.
Hmm.
Beautiful place. When I remember what I know about UCH, even up till where it was her sports then, but the structure was still there.
Okay.
Because I remember about 30 years ago, I went for admission there. And now I was pregnant, and 31 years ago. And, you know, the ward that I was in, I could only enter that ward. The ward that I was in was so beautiful.
Oh my God.
Compared with what you have abroad. Yes, I'm telling you. The old, like compared with what you have in King's Hospital abroad, you know, the Queen's College Hospital. Those are the old hospitals that you said was fashioned after then. Beautiful, so white, so spacious, so clean. They still managed to keep it very clean. The nurses still managed to wear their white, you know. As at that time, I don't know what it's like now. Why are we going back?
Backward.
They are just trifling everything. So we are going to pray.
Yes.
And that is why these people are going abroad to go and see if they don't want to come and die here.
Mm-hmm.
And when they get to so-called abroad, it's a Nigerian or Zokan. That's if they're ever lucky to see them.
Yes.
You see the doctors working on that then.
Yes.
The white doctors working on that, the Nigerian consultant.
Mm.
I take care of them. Meanwhile, we have our own thing. We are going to pray. And we know that this is not only happening in Nigeria. We only know it's happening in Nigeria because we are Nigerians.
Mm.
And since the prayer is for prayer of nations, there are so many nations that are suffering despite the fact that they are very rich. And I think Brazil is one of them. Brazil has oil export.
Mm.
The has something, despite the fact that we are doing it.
Mm.
They want to ask God.
Yes.
God says in his word, and I know this clearly, he says, I hate oppression. No father will like one of his children to be bullying and teaching other children. He will be the one to be beating that child with Jesus. I told him not to beat. I remember in those days, if anybody should offend you, and my parents would say, come and tell me, don't beat your junior one.
Mm-hmm. You are supposed to protect your brothers and sisters.
Okay, what of you know there are some brothers that are there that are bullies, sisters that are bullies.
Mm-hmm.
But what they say is that if your junior one should offend you, come and tell you, hey, do not take the law into your hands.
Yes.
But when you now please constantly that these people are doing, it's offenses. And you know, the interesting thing is that their heart has been so seared. Tell those people that still know that money than everything. Their hearts have been so seared that they do not, they don't care what happens to their own people themselves under them. That is those people that are saying on such errands. Anyway, they have been brainwashed that the guy in the process, they are going to paradise.
Yeah. They are going to Al-Janna.
So that is one of them. So they don't care, but they will never go there. They will never go and fight their fight. They will send their children to fight their fight. So they're going to.
And they said, they were seven women, seven virgin girls. We'll be waiting for them when they die for Islam. And seven virgin. I mean, sometimes we need to think. I don't know.
What's the life that they need to entice them? So we're going to
you are.
These people are being brainwashed.
Evil laws.
Evil laws. They call them lords. Evil lords that they don't push over these people that are the ones that evil bullies that are the ones that are like manipulating those that are lower than them to do that which is against the evil lord.
Mashiach.
Passion Luba.
Oruko Jesu. Let the passion Oluwa Egba Oluwa, the King of the Almighty God. Use your rod. Let the rod of God fall upon them. Deal with them in your wrath and with your rod in the name of Jesus. Deal with every oppressor. Every oppressor of Nigeria, every oppressor, oppress the oppressors in the mighty name of Jesus. Let their rod be used to punish them in the name of Jesus. Let the rod of the oppressors, let it be used to punish them, to destroy them in the mighty name of Jesus. We are praying as a family, as an individual, that in all ramifications, let the rod of the wicked be used to destroy the wicked in the name of Jesus. Let the rod of the wicked be used to destroy the wicked in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. My Father, my God, let the rod of the wicked be used to destroy the wicked in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, every oppressor oppressing the children of God, let all the oppressors be oppressed in the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yes. Yes.
Mighty Almighty. Let them begin to eat their own
voice. Yes. 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 In the name of Jesus. Mighty Almighty God. Show the wicked that you are in control. In the name of Jesus. Let the wickedness of the wicked be upon the wicked in the name of Jesus. Father.